Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at carbocation intermediates. These are common reactive intermediates in many chemical reactions, and as we start to do more synthesis, we're going to see them commonly. So we need to have an understanding of what they are and what makes them more or less stable in a reaction. So this is a carbocation intermediate right here. It's a carbon with three bonds and no lone pairs of electrons, and so it doesn't have a full octet. It has an empty p orbital, and it's got a positive charge. So the carbocation intermediate is trigonal planar. The three bonding groups coming off of it are all in one plane with bond angles of 120 degrees, and then it has that empty p orbital. That makes it an electron acceptor and an electrophile. Carbocation intermediates can have four different substitution patterns depending on what's bonded to them. So if a carbocation has no other carbons on it, just hydrogens, then we would call that a methyl carbocation. If the carbon with a positive charge on it has one other carbon on it, that would be a primary carbocation. When there are two other carbons, it would be a secondary carbocation. And when every available substituent is a carbon, that would be a tertiary carbocation. So remember, to have that positive charge, the maximum number of groups I could have coming off that central positively charged carbon is three. In terms of relative stability, the more substituted a carbon is with a positive charge, the more stable it's going to be. So I'm going to write us a note. More substituted carbocation is more stable. And that will end up having an impact on product distributions. So there are potentially different intermediates we could go through in a reaction, and their substitution and relative stability can be a predictor for what major or minor product we can see. So on the next page, we'll take a look at what factors impact those relative stabilities. The first factor that can influence relative stability as it pertains to substitution is the inductive effect. So induction is when electron density is pushed through a sigma framework, so through single type bonds. The carbocation carbon is positively charged, and it can be stabilized by neighboring carbon atoms. Those sp3 hybridized carbons in particular are not very electronegative, and so they're going to push electron density away from the carbon atoms that are exterior and towards the central carbon atom of the carbocation that is electron deficient, and that stabilizes that charge. So the more carbon atoms there are attached to the carbocation, the more opportunities there are for that inductive type stabilization. So the other factor that impacts the stability of carbocations is hyperconjugation. And this is sort of a unique interaction where the carbon-hydrogen or carbon-carbon bond from next door lines up in plane with the empty p orbital on my carbocation, and it shares electron density across that, almost like what a pi bond looks like. And it stabilizes that positive charge. So there's electron density here in these orbitals, and I've sort of drawn like the s orbital for the hydrogen atom and then the sp3 type hybrid orbital for the carbon that are overlapping to form that bond. If they line up just right, so they're in line with the p orbital on the carbocation, they can share electron density over to that carbon, making it less electron deficient and more stabilized. So the more substitution, the more opportunities there are for hyperconjugation to occur. And that, again, contributes to the relative stability being dependent on the substitution of the carbon atom. The last thing we'll talk about is the impact of resonance on carbocation stability. So in the molecule that I've drawn here, I've got a positive charge, and then adjacent to that is a pi bond. That means that these pi electrons could move over through resonance, and that would give me this structure here. So for this system, there's a shared charge. The charge is delocalized over multiple atoms as opposed to being localized on one, and that's always going to be a stabilizing factor for the molecule. So a resonance stabilized carbocation will be the most stable, and then after considering resonance, you would look to relative substitution to determine the stability of the carbocation intermediate. So this has been a look at relative stability of carbocation intermediates. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends.